Okay, online and offline students, can you hear me? Okay, so in the last session we have started about the database and we have seen about like what is database and why we are using database and what types of databases are there, and also we have seen about the differences between DBMS and RDBMS, and also we have seen about ACID properties like atomicity, consistency, isolation and durability. So all these properties we have discussed in the last session. Okay, now as I said, we are going to work with Oracle database. Okay, so today I will tell you about how to download and install the Oracle database. Okay, so by tomorrow or by Monday at least you make sure that you install so that you can practice it. Okay, so how to download it? So you can go to the Google Chrome, and in the Google I will anyway share the screenshots also. Like you can type here whatever the version of Oracle you want to download. So Oracle 21c download. So when you click this, you will get the option like this. So then you can select here and make sure that what is your operating system. Some people might be using Linux or Windows or Mac OS, different operating systems will be there. So download according to your operating system. Okay, so what is your database? Okay, one thing I will tell you, like Oracle 21c, let us download here Express Edition. Okay, it is easy for downloading and installing for us. Okay, so now Oracle 21c Express Edition, you can download and install it. So when you click this, you will have multiple options. Either it is for Windows or Linux, what you want. Now we are using Windows operating system. So we will be downloading the Oracle database for what? Windows. So now you will be downloading the database for Oracle Windows. So you, when you click this, you will be getting in the downloads. You can check here and you can go to the downloads, and in the downloads, okay, I have already downloaded. So you will get the file like this. Okay, Oracle XE as a zip file. How you will get? As a zip file. So now you have to unzip it. You have to right click this and click on extract all. What do you have to do? Extract all. So when you say extract all, you will get a file. Without extracting, you don't down install it. Okay, mundu extract cheyandi. So when you extract the file, you will get like this, Oracle XE. Okay, so Express Edition, Oracle Express Edition 21. Then after that, you have to open this. Got it? So now once you open this, you have to click on what? Setup file. So when you click on the setup file, it will start installing for you in your PC. So generally Oracle will take some time. Okay, it will not complete very fastly. It will take at least 10 minutes to sometimes also. Okay, you have to click on yes, then it will get installed on your PC. Okay, in between while installing, it will ask you the enter the password. Okay, by default it will store in some location. It will ask you the, it will display on the screen like username is sys or system or sysdba, and it will ask you to enter the password and re-enter the password. Okay, don't use so complicated capital, small, like the symbols and all, because later if you forget again, recovering it will be difficult. Understood? So give some simple password. We are learning it, we are using it for practice purpose only, right? It is not in a real company and all. So you give a simple password, re-enter the password, and you continue. It will be saving in your computer. Understood? So like this, these are the steps to download the database. What you have to do here, you have to go to the Google Chrome, and here type Oracle 21c Express Edition. Do Express Edition only. Why? Because it is easy for you for installing and practicing and all. Otherwise, it will be for you complete other database means it will be difficult for installing. If there is some other, it will show you error. But this will be easy. Okay. And while someone is installing, you might face some challenges. Like sometimes for some people, it will be rolling back. Okay. Half it will install and it will get rolling back. And at that point of time, you have to make a small modification. Change the folder by installing. మనం ఏదైనా ఇన్స్టాల్ చేసేటప్పుడు ఒక ఫోల్డర్ లో సేవ్ అవుతుంది కదా, ఫోల్డర్ చూపిస్తుంది కదా మీకు, ఆ ఫోల్డర్ ని మార్చండి, వేరే ఫోల్డర్ ఇవ్వండి. బై డిఫాల్ట్ ఒక చోట సేవ్ అవుతుంది, జస్ట్ చేంజ్ ద ఫోల్డర్ నేమ్. సో వెన్ యూ చేంజ్ ద ఫోల్డర్ నేమ్, ఇట్ విల్ ఇన్స్టాల్. ఇఫ్ స్టిల్ ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ గెటింగ్ ఎనీ ప్రాబ్లమ్, దోస్ హు ఆర్ అటెండింగ్ ఆఫ్లైన్ బ్రింగ్ యువర్ ల్యాప్టాప్స్, ఐ విల్ చెక్. Okay, so we will be seeing. So like that you can install the Oracle database. So you have to click Oracle 21c Express Edition and then you click on this and download according to your operating system. So when you click on this, it will be downloaded. See, when you click on this, you will get downloaded here. So it will be downloading. Okay, since I have already done, I am just canceling this. So once you have downloaded, you can view in the downloads and then extract it. Remember it. Okay, extract cheyandi. Extract cheyakunda setup file click cheyakandi. Okay, so first extract it. When you extract it, the zip file, you will get the file like this. Again, with the same name tone, but zip file ga undadu. So zip file, you know, right? You will be getting in this format. Like this you will be seeing. So that you have to unzip it, then you will be getting a folder like this, and in this you have to click on what? Setup file. So when you click the setup file, when you click S, it will be keep on installing. Okay, so for me it will give you an message like it's already there, do you want to remove it? Okay, already undi kada, andukani it will give a suggestion to me. You have chosen to remove. Okay, I will not remove it since it is already there. So you can just keep on continuing. Okay, koncham patience ga wait cheyandi, inka avvatledu avvatledu anukunda. It will take little time. Okay, so it will be installed. Once it is installed in your PC, okay, then you can go to the start, and here you have to type SQL. What is that? SQL. So when you type SQL, you will get the SQL like this command prompt. Like manaki, you know, command prompt, everyone, those who are using Windows or any operating system, you will be getting the command prompt, right? Okay, in the same way you will get the SQL command prompt. Okay, so there we will enter the username and password. Online students, are you following? Since continuous class is there, they did no, no one has joined today. Okay, yesterday many of them have joined. So is it okay for you, continuous class? Are you feeling any hectic or anything? All right. because online students, they did not join. Why? Because I thought you can listen and go, right? Otherwise, again, you have to come on two timings. It will be difficult for you. So I thought this timing will be comfortable. Otherwise, anywhere between 12 to 1, you have to again come at 12 and again come at the evening. It's difficult for you. Okay. So first, we have to enter the username. After installing, so see, once if it gets successfully installed, okay, then you have to go to here, start, and type here SQL. What you have to type? SQL. It will show you like SQL plus and click on what? Open. So when you click on open, then you will get a prompt like this. Window like this. Okay, and just control plus, it will increase the font size. Okay, just here I am entering the username system. This is common for everything. Everyone, it is common. You can use sys or system, and the password is like what you enter during the installation. generally for Gmail or Yahoo Mail or any password, it will show stars or dots, right? But here it will not show that also. I have typed the password, but it will not allow you to see how many number of characters you typed also. That is more secured, right? మామూలుగా అయితే మనకి పాస్వర్డ్ డాట్స్ స్టార్స్ లాగైనా ఎన్ని లెటర్స్ ప్రెస్ చేసామనైనా తెలుస్తుంది అవతల వాళ్ళకి, చూసిన వాళ్ళకి. బట్ హియర్ యూ డజంట్ నో ఇట్. ఓకే, బట్ ఐ హావ్ టైప్డ్ ద పాస్వర్డ్, దెన్ ఇట్ హాస్ కనెక్టెడ్ టు ద ఎక్స్ప్రెస్ ఎడిషన్. ఓకే, లైక్ దిస్ యూ విల్ బి గెటింగ్. ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ సక్సెస్ఫుల్లీ ఇన్స్టాల్డ్, ఓకే, దెన్ యూ విల్ గెట్ లైక్ డేటాబేస్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ ఇన్స్టాల్డ్ అండ్ ఆల్. ఓకే, దిస్ ఈస్ ద ప్రాసెస్ ఫర్ డౌన్లోడింగ్ అండ్ ఇన్స్టాలింగ్ ద డేటాబేస్. Okay, all of you, you can download according to that process. I will provide some screenshot on it on one document so that you can follow the same steps. Okay, type Oracle 21c Express Edition. And once you get this, select the first one. Database Express Edition XE. Then after selecting this, you have to select on Windows. See, remember about your operating system. What is your operating system? You have to select that. So as of now, I am telling Express Edition for Windows 64-bit operating system. Okay, then it will get, okay, click on the file. It will get downloaded. Click on file. So it will get downloaded. And after that, extract the file. Whatever the file you have downloaded, you have to extract the file. And once it gets extracted, then open the file and then double click setup file. Okay. And when you click the double click the setup file, then click S and then continue. So in between, you have to give the password. So it will give the username and just give the password. Don't change the folder first only. If it rollbacks, then change the folder. Otherwise, you do not change any folder. So just give the password. Okay, remember that password also. Okay, give the password and then remember. These are the steps for installing the database. Downloading and installing. Got it? So now once it is installed, you have to go to, once if it is installed, then what are the steps? How to open SQL command line. So our database, how to open the SQL command line. So for this, what you have to do is go to start or search, whatever you want, you can go it and search for SQL command line and then click on open. So once you open, you will see a command prompt like this. Okay, what you have to do it, I'm just closing this. You have to go to the search or start and here, select here SQL command line or SQL. Then click on open. Okay, then once you open this, then you will be getting the command prompt. SQL and then click on open. Then you will get the command prompt like this. Okay, so once you get the command prompt, enter the username system and password also I'm entering. If I give any wrong password, see I'm giving something. So then it is telling invalid username or password. So once again, I'm entering the username and then password. So it is successfully logged in. So if you enter wrong password, you will get a message like this. Otherwise, you will get successfully logged in. Okay, so I have they created Google Classroom for you. I think they shared the link, right? So I will share the notes on SQL also. Yesterday also I have not sent. I will send both together. So now you will enter the username and password. Then you are ready for executing your database queries. Okay, these are the steps to follow for downloading and installing your Oracle database. Okay, by Monday everyone download and install it. Then you can practice all the queries and all. Okay, online students, is it clear? Everyone, Madhavi and Venkat Sai. Okay. Okay. So as I said, whatever you are doing in the RDBMS, Relational Database Management System, we will be storing data in terms of what? Tables. In DBMS means you will be storing data in terms of files or any XML file or anything you will be storing. But here you will store in terms of tables. So for as we discussed, database means what? It will store huge amount of data. So how it is going to be stored? As we discussed, we have two things that you are going to learn in this module, SQL and PLSQL. So SQL and PLSQL means this is structured query language. SQL stands for what? Structured query language. So this language is common for all the databases. Oracle or MySQL or PostgreSQL, any SQL, this any database, this SQL is common language. So here we will be having the queries to connect to the database and apply, store the data, retrieve data, delete or any modifications we can do with the database. Okay, but it will follow some rules and how the queries are written, how the queries are created in database. Like this, we have some features. So all the queries are divided into three parts, three types we have here. So the first one is DDL. What is that? DDL. DDL stands for Data Definition Language. Data Definition Language. Okay, that is stands for DDL. And second one, we have DML. DML stands for Data Manipulation Language. DDL and DML. And the next one we have TCL, or we can tell DCL also. This is where we can call it as Data Control Language. So these are the three things we have. And we can also tell one more, TCL also, Transaction Control Language. Okay, Transaction Control Language. So everything, whatever the queries we are writing in our database, they are modified or they are divided into these three types of queries: DDL, DML and DCL. DDL stands for, as I said, Data Definition. So here we have the queries that are used for creating tables. Okay, as we said, in RDBMS all the data we store in terms of what? Tables, right? So here we have the commands to create the tables. Okay, and once we create the tables, we will make modification to the table, like insertion, deleting the data, modifying the data, updating the data and all. So those are called as what? Manipulations, right? Making changes. So for creating tables, we whatever the query comes under, those come under DDL category. Whatever the manipulation, DML, in the DML we get something like insertion, deletion, updation. These all come under what? DML. Okay, delete and all everything. About the table data. Table data lo ante oka employee information gaani, student gaani, books gaani, edanna information meeda changes chesthe daanni manam DML lo chustam. Ade table related structure ante table create chesina, table structure ni marchalanukunna, alter cheyalanna ante suppose first you created table with employee ID, name, mobile number ante three columns icharu. Next meer inko column add cheddam anukuntunnaru, address, designation. So atla table structure ni modify chesthe adi a category lo kelthundi, DDL. Adi table data untundi kada, employee ID gaani, salary gaani, lekapothe inkedana mobile number gaani, data ni modify chesthe danni em antam manam, data manipulation antam, insertion, deletion and updation. So now again DCL and TCL, these have the queries like, as I said yesterday, in the durability we have to save the commands. So for saving the commands we have what? Commit. So whenever after doing some set of transactions ante manam tables create chesam, insert chesam, delete chesam, itla konni transactions chesaka manam chesina prati transaction database lo save ayi undali. So for that we have to use what? Commit. And like this commit we also have rollback. What is that? Rollback. So rollback will act as a undo. Manam word kaani edana document lo previous transaction ni cancel cheyalante em use chestam? Undo kada, control z. So ante just chesina previous transaction cancel avvali, daniki manam em antam ikkada? Rollback. And also there are something called grant and revoke. What is that? Grant, revoke. So what are this grant and revoke? See, for whoever is working on database, suppose you are working on database as your SQL developer or something, so who is the admin or of that Oracle database, they will grant you some permission and they will revoke some permissions, correct? So permissions are like you can insert some data, you can make some data, but they will give you restriction for deletion. You cannot delete. So some permissions can be given grant and some permissions can be revoked. So atla manam users ki permissions ni grant cheyochu, revoke cheyochu. That's upon administrator wish it is. If he wants, he will give you permission on insertion, deletion, or he will revoke the permission on deletion. So like that you will have the permissions given. So those all come under this DCL and TCL. So these are the category of commands we have: DDL, DML, DCL or TCL. Okay, understood everyone? Online students, is it clear? Any doubt is there, please let me know. So now we will learn step by step all these commands, how to create, insert like different tables and delete the data and everything we will be seeing in the database by step by step. So first we will learn in the database how to create a table and insertion, and after insertion, deletion, updation, altering, everything we will be seeing step by step. And creating table also we have many ways to create. Okay, so once again I'm telling, see, in SQL structured query language, to work with the database we have some queries all divided into three categories: DDL, DML and TCL or DCL. DDL stands for data definition language. Okay, so in this we will work on the table structure, like creating, altering the table. Okay, DML means data manipulation, ante table lo unna data meeda changes chestam. Vaatiki em use chestam manam? Insertion, deletion, updation, any modification we will call it as what? DML. And next, data control or TCL, both will get grant, revoke, ante permissions. And then commit and rollback for saving and unsaving the transactions. So these all are the categories. Got it? So first let us see this DDL commands. So in this DDL command, first I'm going to see about the create table. What is that? Create. So first manam data ni store chesi retrieve cheyalanna first manaku oka table create ayi undali. So how to create the table? We will be writing, first I'll write the syntax. Create table, you have to give the table name, ante table ku oka name ivvali. And then you have to write the column name and the data type. What we have to write? Data type. And you will provide the size. Like this, you can create any number of columns and then close it and end with the semicolon. Okay. So how you will write? Create table, table name, column name and data type, size. Like this you will create. Got it? This is the syntax of the table you have to create. Now let us see the example of creating, like create table. Okay, what is the table name? Suppose you are creating the table on one student or any company or anything, you can take. Suppose I'm creating table on Oracle, or let us say on group. So I'm creating one table on group. And here I am writing ID. Every group will have what? One ID. So here the data type is given as what? Number. I am giving size as 5. So ikkada manam a type of data isthunnam antaniki manaki data types untai. So what are the data types we have in Oracle or in this database? Number. What is the first one? We have number. The number, if you are giving, it can store only numbers. Numbers and numbers with decimal points also. Okay, suppose if you are giving 5, 7, means 5 numerical places and 7 decimal places. Okay, if you are giving only 5, that means the number length can be up to 5, and number of 5, comma, and every group will have some name. So I'm giving the column name as what? G name. So now group name is, it is combination of characters, right? So the data type here we have as what? Char. What is the data type? Char. And the group name is not a single character, right? It will have group of characters. So you can give some group of characters as what? 16. Ante enta peddadaina undochu. Okay. So like that you will have. So remember, when you are giving the size as more, you cannot reduce the size. Manam size ni increase cheyochu gaani reduce cheyalem endukante you will get an error when you reduce, that there might be loss of data, correct kada? Size ni increase chesinanta matrana data emi manam lose avam, ante oka name group of the name manam full stack an isthunam. Okay, full stack ichinappudu dani size 5 an icham manam, 5 or 6 icham, name saripoyindi. So anta size avasaram ledan takista full stack anedi saripodu kada, if you are reducing to 3 to. So it won't allow you to reduce the size. You can increase the size always, but you cannot reduce the size. Remember that. And group name, and also you have some group address. So in this group address, when you are giving, sometimes the address, will it be character or number? Address character lo untunda, number lo untunda? Number untada? Combination untundi. So when you have like that, you can give varchar or varchar 2, and you can specify the size. Okay, so itla meer enni columns kavalante anni columns ivvachu. Okay, group ID, group name and group address. Like this you can give some address or where it is created. Okay, like this you can give. And after creating end, we will end with what? Semicolon. Got it? Understood? So like this we will be creating. Now let us open the command prompt here. Once again I am closing and opening it. See, just go here, SQL, and select the SQL. So it will open. Just to, I'm increasing the font so that you can see. Enter the username as system, and then the password I'm giving as something. And now it is successfully logged in. So what is the command for creating the table? I'm creating create table. Okay, something I have created the table name as what? Group. So for the group, I'm giving ID, which is of data type number. And you can give size as 5 or edana size ivachu. And group name char, I'm giving some 7 or 6. And then group address, I'm giving GADDRESS. And here I'm giving varchar 2 of some 23. And semicolon. So like this you are creating. Okay, in okay, there is some predefined word for the group, so it is not taking. So we will be giving group 1, 2 or 11th. So what we got? Table created. We got the table created. So how to check whether table is created or not? Okay, there should be something to check the structure of the table that we have created. So for that we will be seeing description command. What is that? DEC. DEC stands for description. So DESC, and what is the table name? Group 11. So I have, so we got, so this is like ID, group name and address, and this is the data type size. Okay, till we did not insert any data, we have just created the table with the data types. Understood? So manam oka table create chesam with some specific data types. All of you understood? Everyone, online students, is it clear how to create the table? Okay, Madhavi, you have given something both. I missed that message. Is it clear, everyone? How to create the table? So one more table I will be creating. See, so for the create, okay, I'm giving like trainee or something. So if the table already exists, it will give us error. Suppose I'm creating again, create table, table name, then what it is telling? Name is already existing by the object. So if the table is already present, then it will not create again. You can create only once. So to save these transactions, you have to give one commit. So then it will be saved, all the transactions that you are creating. So we have to create again. If you want to create one more table, you have to write the same query. So all of you, please write once again. Oksar meer oka table rasi chudandi, same as follow this. Create at least 5 columns. Online students, you also just a query raayandi. Something like if you're creating for employee ID, employee name, employee address, salary, designation, department, phone number, like this you can give. At least 5 to 7 columns you can create. So just check with the data type also what you can give. And when you are giving mobile number, so you can strictly give the mobile number can be 10 numbers or 11, because you should not give more than that. Atla meeru restrictions ivachu. If someone is giving more than that, it should not take it. So everyone got laptop? Anyone have? You have? Teleda? Okay, fine. Intlo install just chudandi. Avvakapothe repu teeskurandi okasari. Endukante install chesesi pette Monday nunchi practice cheyochu. Endukante complete database lo ila queries e untayi. Nenu so oorike cheptu unte meer practice cheyyandi em artham kadu. Ante okay create avutunda anipistundi gaani meer type chesi chusi insert chestene meeku artham avutundi. Andukani. Okay. మీకు అర్థమవుతుందండి, కొత్తగా జాయిన్ అయ్యారు, మీకు ఆల్రెడీ ఐడియా ఉందా? ఫస్ట్ టైం వింటున్నారా? ఫస్ట్ టైం వింటున్నారా? సో ఇది కంప్యూటర్స్ ఆ నాన్ కంప్యూటర్ బ్యాక్గ్రౌండ్ అండి? కంప్యూటర్స్ బ్యాక్గ్రౌండ్ అయినా కాదు, ఎలక్ట్రానిక్సా? ఓకే, సో ఫుల్ స్టాక్ జాయిన్ అయ్యారా? ఓన్లీ ఓన్లీ SQL? లోకేష్ ఫ్రెండ్ ఓకే, తను రాలేదు ఇవాళ, తను ఫుల్ స్టాక్ కాదు కదా, బట్ డెమోస్ వరకు 1-2-3 డేస్ రమ్మని అంటే ఊరికే వింటే ఒకవేళ జాయిన్ అవ్వాలనిపిస్తే. అండ్ ఆన్లైన్ కూడా జాయిన్ అవ్వలేదు పవన్ కుమార్ అండ్ తారకేశ్వరి, అనుజ్ఞ. రాసారా అండి క్వరీ అందరూ? ఓకే, ఆన్లైన్ స్టూడెంట్స్ ఓకే. క్రియేట్ టేబుల్ స్టూడెంట్ ఐడి నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ 6, నేమ్ కేర్ ఆఫ్ 20, అడ్రస్ ఓకే, మార్క్స్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ 10. ఎస్, యూ కెన్ క్రియేట్ లైక్ దిస్. అండ్ వన్ థింగ్, ఒరాకిల్ ఈజ్ నాట్ కేస్ సెన్సిటివ్, యూ కెన్ రైట్ క్యాపిటల్ స్మాల్, నో ప్రాబ్లమ్. హియర్ యూ హ్యావ్ క్రియేటెడ్ టేబుల్ విత్ స్టూడెంట్ and when you are retrieving you can use capital also. Okay, so like you can also see when you are viewing the description, DESC, suppose you are writing like group capital G11, then also it will give you, no problem. But data is sensitive, like what you are typing data in the database, that you have to follow exactly same thing, but table and outside structure, it is not case sensitive. Understood? Okay, so once I will take the attendance also, everyone. I have missed taking in UI, some people have left. Online students I can take it, no problem, it will be saved. But offline students, two people left, right? You know their names? Three left, no? Perlu gurtunnaya meeku? సంహిత, సందీప్, సందీప్, వన్ మోర్ గర్ల్ లెఫ్ట్, నో ఐ ఫర్గాట్, ఓకే, టుమారో ఐ విల్ ఆస్క్, వీ విల్ ఆస్క్ దెమ్. ఓకే, సుభాషిణి, రైట్, సుభాషిణి, తేజశ్రీ, somehow I'm remembering some names. Anusha, Namrata, Shamini, okay, you are not in UI, no? Okay, no problem. Okay, Vipul also not, he is waiting whether I'm remembering or not. Some names I remember. Madhu. Madhu, okay. Today you gave interview. Rohit. And I know he was Krishna Chetan. Okay. So Vinita or someone online they attend. Okay, online student I think. So Vinita. Someone, okay, they gave some interview. All of you apply for mock interviews who have not given on HTML and CSS. Some of them have given, they told they are giving good, few things they are missing, and a few people are like missing in communication, little bit, not much also, like little they are in communication problem was there. Anyway, you are attending communication classes, right? You will be improving how to answer and all. Okay, don't be in hurry also. Whatever question they asked, be relaxed and answer confidently. That's it. If you do not know the answer, tell them like I could not get it. I will just go through it and answer next time. You can be answering like that. Okay. So any more doubts on today's and yesterday's session? So first you have to install database. That's why I'm just waiting. Install it and come. Tomorrow we will see about first normalization. What are different types of normalization? మీరు మండే కల్లా ఏమన్నా ప్రాబ్లమ్ ఉంటే ఇన్స్టాల్ చేసుకుంటారని ఇవాళే చెప్పాను ఇన్స్టాలేషన్. యాక్చువల్లీ ఐ థాట్ ఆఫ్ టెల్లింగ్ నార్మలైజేషన్. టుమారో ఐ టెల్ అబౌట్ వాట్ ఈస్ నార్మలైజేషన్ అండ్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ నార్మల్ ఫార్మ్స్ అండ్ విల్ కంటిన్యూ దిస్ డేటాబేస్ క్రియేషన్. ఓకే, ఎనీ మోర్ డౌట్స్? ఎనీవన్ గాట్ ఇట్? ఓకే ఓకే, దెన్ విల్ కంటిన్యూ ఇన్ ద నెక్స్ట్ సెషన్. ఫర్ టుడే ఐఎమ్ లీవింగ్ లిటిల్ 5 మినిట్స్ ఎర్లీ. Okay, so everyone, Madhavi and Venkat Sai, if you have any doubts, you can ask me. Otherwise, you can leave the session.